There you see the ballots being counted in Pennsylvania. Usually that's the end of the process in the election. In this election, it is the beginning of the end. We have a long way to go. There are going to be legal challenges to these counts. So let's bring in our legal team, Kate Shaw and Dan Abrams. Kate, let me begin with you on that point. We're seeing the ballots be counted now. You have several states that are almost certainly going to lead to either automatic recounts or challenges from who's ever behind and recounts there. We know it's going to happen in Pennsylvania as well. So walk everybody through that process and where the legal challenges are likely.
Sure thing, George. So in every state, there's either an automatic recount or a recount that a candidate can request when the margin is close enough. So sometimes that's half a percentage point, sometimes it's a quarter, sometimes it's even a point. So I think you're right, we're almost certain to see at least a couple of states within that margin. And if we do, it's all but certain that one of the candidates is going to request a recount if state law doesn't automatically provide for it. So, you know, we've been cautioning Americans to be patient before the election, and I think we really do need to sort of redouble those efforts at, you know, broadcasting the need for patience, because it could be weeks if we're in recount territory before we know the winner of at least, you know, one or more of these states. So those processes will unfold much like the counting is unfolding now. So those votes will be counted again, either by machine or potentially by hand. And either at the same time or after all that is done, there could be legal challenges filed to various decisions made about how to count particular categories of ballots.
Dan Abrams, we've seen this movie before back in 2000, but it was only in one state, the state of Florida, where they had that recount, finally decided by about 500 votes after the Supreme Court stopped the counting. This year, you have the potential to have that happen in several states, and again, potentially, it could go to the Supreme Court after appeals.
It could, and remember that each state has different laws and different triggers for possible recounts, and different rules for which ballots are counted. So don't expect, if there are multiple state challenges, a sort of one-size-fits-all Supreme Court appeal. It will have to be specifically state by state, issue by issue, potentially ballot by ballot, that gets appealed. But as we talked about before, I think whoever ends up on top at the time the legal fights start, meaning really once the recounts have happened, whoever's on top is at a significant advantage. You don't want to be the person who's lost or losing and trying to appeal to the Supreme Court to save you.
And Kate Shaw, quickly, John Roberts, Chief Justice John Roberts, also probably does not want to get in the middle of this for the sake of the court.
I think that's right. Chief Justice Roberts cares a great deal about the court's institutional legitimacy, doesn't want the court at the center of what looks like a political fight. And we will see if enough other members of the court agree with him that the court might try to find a way essentially not to step into the middle of this election dispute, potentially to hand over to Congress responsibility for deciding some of these disputed elections, or essentially saying what it didn't say 20 years ago, that these are state law questions and the Supreme Court actually has no role in resolving these cases. So that is possible. And of course, the huge X factor here is the newest member of the court, Justice Amy Coney Barrett. We don't know what she would do in such a case.
Whether she'll even join the case. Kate Shaw, thanks very much.
Well, hey there, GMA fans. Robin Roberts here. Thanks for checking out our YouTube channel. Lots of great stuff here. So go on, click the subscribe button right over here to get more of awesome videos and content from GMA every day, anytime. We thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the morning on GMA.